There's a study that I've never been able to shake, and I keep coming back to it. And interestingly, this vegetable is currently being absolutely demonised in the media, with many people limiting it or avoiding it completely. And yet in a fascinating set of experiments, albeit in vitro, as they were conducted in a petri dish, it came out as beating so many other vegetables when it comes to its cancer-fighting effects. And when I think of this vegetable, I never really associated it with powerful anti-cancer benefits. And yet this study Dr. Greger discusses seems to say otherwise. So in this video, we're going to take a look at that research, and then we'll come back and address the legitimate concerns with this vegetable. So let's hear now from Dr. Michael Greger of nutritionfacts.org.
Some of these vegetables target multiple cancers at the same time. So using these groundbreaking new data, let's play which is healthier. Out of the five, spinach is number one against breast cancer. Remember, the farther down, the better it is at slowing down these cancer cells. Number one against brain tumors. Number one against kidney cancer. Number one against lung cancer and pediatric brain tumors. That's why we need to feed our kids spinach. Number one against pancreatic cancer, prostate cancer, and stomach cancer. Now, it's not number one overall. There are 16 vegetables more powerful at stopping stomach cancer growth than spinach. But out of those five salad greens, spinach wins out across the board against every cancer type tested.
The other salad greens it was pitted against were radicchio, romaine lettuce, endive, and Boston lettuce. It would be really interesting if kale had been on the greens list, but the researchers were trying to emulate what most people would typically put in a salad. One of my favourite facts about spinach is a single spoonful of spinach has as much lutein and zeaxanthin as 9 eggs. And these are two of the most powerful antioxidants, especially for brain and eye health. In fact, lutein and zeaxanthin are the only dietary carotenoids that accumulate in our retina, and they're also amongst the most dominant carotenoids in human brain tissue, where they account for 66 to 77% of total carotenoid concentration. Now, it's true, spinach is high in oxalates, which is why Dr. Greger recommends we don't eat cups a day of spinach, but we'll look in detail at this next.